Your Excellency, the Governor, and this congregation, nothing will happen if God is not in it. And as I listened to your speech, as I sat in as a visitor, I want to ask my people to authentically put God first in what you are doing. And I want to refer to Proverbs 10:19, and this is for Vihiga County particularly, the political leadership, the religious leadership, and even the educational leadership. Proverbs 10:19, when there are many words, wrongdoing is unavoidable. But one who restrains his lips is wise. There are too many words in Vihiga County. And I wish I could say it more candidly, but just remember Proverbs 10:19, when there are many words, wrongdoing is unavoidable. But one who restrains his lips is wise. I come from Lunyerere here. That's where both my parents are buried. And I'm settled in Kakamega. I'm the chairman of Kakamega Water Company. I'm chairman of the Budget and Economic Forum. I was the chairman for the conversion of Mumias into a city. I'm the chairman of the Kakamega County Education Board, and so on and so forth. I want us to learn something. Let us avoid too many words. And I wish I could say it better. Honorable Sosi, you talked about court cases. And you talked about the 300 litigations. What does that tell me as I sat there? I was asking, what has become of our people? I think of the Banyore people, my heart goes to the Church of God. I think of the Tiriki people, I see a lot of Salvation Army and PAG and other Quaker denominations. I think of my own Maragoli people, the Friends, the PAG, and other churches, Divine Church and so on. So where are these litigations coming from? And I want to speak from the heart. There is one virtue that this county must embrace, and that is the virtue of humility. Because in 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 5 to 6, put on that apron of humility, so that God may exalt you in due time. And God resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble. So if we have litigations, that is arrogance. When we have litigations, that is arrogance, and God will resist us. So instead of the governor working on plans to help our people, he's busy fighting not to be taken to court or to be jailed. Abandu betu badiriji abarogori nenda banyore firane kunyasaye numuntu nakogose uziwi na mehasi umbole wa Kongo sera chini nda kusame. That is not our character. In fact, one of the reasons that Honorable Musalia is so attractive in this country is because of our character, humility. It is not a weakness, it is wisdom. And so when I come back home, and my governor, and by the way, me, I am a political orphan. Those of you who know me, I used to be very active when the late Daniel Toroitich Arap Moi was alive. So when he died, I'm an orphan. I'm neither ODM, nor Jubilee, nor none. I'm a political orphan. Yeah, so when I talk as a neutral person. Politics doesn't interest me anymore. That's why when I read this report, I asked the DG, we have done all this in Vihiga, and yet the noise and the abuses and the disrespect that goes on about our county out there ashames many of us. And I want to say this as I finish. In genuine humility, there is enormous power. Just look at the home. When we were growing up as children, when children are growing up, they fear their father because their father uses force. But the mama remains meek and mild, carries the apron of humility. There is so much power, such that when your children grow up and become adolescents, they no longer listen to the father, they listen to the mother. In humility, that's why old men who are sitting here like me, your mobile phone never rings an M-Pesa tone. But the mama's mobile is always ringing. Yeah. God has given me many children, and they are now grown-ups. And sometimes I want to send Agnes some money, and the Safaricom tells me, tell her to empty the phone. Sasa nakuuliza, what is happening? And I say, oh, so-and-so sent this, so-and-so. They will not tell you the truth. They have sent me this to do this. They have sent me this to do this. I can no longer control my children. And now I use my wife, who is sick and grounded, to talk to them. Because she just has to say one word. Bana bami mkorant. Finished. My power is gone. In genuine humility, there is power. So the leaders of Vihiga, this is my message. As a son, as a brother, as a father to some of you, free yourself from the demands of your ego. And there's no limit to where you can go. There is too much of I. Free yourself from the demands of your ego. Let go of your desire to control others, and you'll vastly improve the ability to control, focus, and direct your own actions. Let go of the illusion that you already know it all, and you open yourself to higher levels of enlightenment. I'm appealing to the leaders, church leaders, political leaders, school leaders, move beyond the need to blame and you gain a greater degree of responsibility, and get past the impulse to place judgments on others, and you'll be able to focus much more clearly on matters of real and lasting value. I am pleading for all of us, give up the thought that you are better than everyone else and a whole new world of opportunity opens to you. Please stop seeking unfair advantage. I was writing these notes. Stop seeking unfair advantage and you'll be free to develop an unstoppable effectiveness as a leader. Quit demanding the most and start experiencing the best. I don't know what I'm saying, but I'm saying something. So my plea to all of you is live each moment with humility, with love, with respect, and gratitude for the whole of life that surrounds you, and you'll find a treasure that has no end. When I had my difficult times in Moi University, I could have gone to court because somebody in that council gave me a mark that I've never got in my life. Mugarizi knows he was my classmate. Yeah. The Mugarizi, they got so many K's in maths because the teacher used me as a benchmark. Now I'm this sub will come and Noranda Conor will come. Mugarizi are no marks Gabiri Bas. But somebody gave me 41%. Somebody who's not even the age of my daughter, and somebody, I did that to God. I walked away, and now I look back and say that was God's storm so that I could be dispersed to another place. Amen. Let us be men and women of humility. And God will lift us in a very, very special way. Number two, as I finish, I want to talk to the Luhya Nation. And I want to tell the Luhya Nation that the secret sits at the center. Governor Tichiro, the secret sits at the center. But our people are fond of dancing on the periphery. They like dancing on the periphery and really showing how they know how to dance. But nobody is seeing you because the secret sits at the center. It is at the center that there is heat. It is at the center that there is the heart. We are too far away from the center. And I can see we are still dancing at the periphery. Yes. Because when we dance at the periphery, Honorable Tichiro, that is where we are feeling at home. That is where there is familiarity. The notes I wrote here. That is where there is safety. That's where there is comfort. I attended some funeral in my area not so long ago, and I was shocked that in a funeral setting, the mourners are asked to line up to be given money. I was revulsed. The word in English, I felt so demeaned as a human being. I went to that funeral to mourn the dead. And you can see mamas being lined up so that they can be given muhefugin. By the way, Maragonis, Banyore, Abadiriji, that is the worst level you can drive yourself to. When we were growing up, Uzile Gondi Siri Nidara, Mumani Mama, Buya Kumba, Siri, Akuwala Akuensia. My own mother, they never allowed me to accept free money from somebody. That kills your spirit as a person. It kills your spirit and you will never become. There are blessings in inadequacy. When you are inadequate, you are supposed to work harder so that you can become. God rest my father, rest his soul in peace. He was a driver, and I grew up in the slums of Kibera, in Saba. We used to stay in one room with my father. Nalala hapa, kwa godoro ya saiso, mi nalala hapa. And he kept on telling, mwanange osome. That was his message. My mother never came. My mother never came to Nairobi. How could she come? We were staying in one room. But there was a blessing in that inadequacy. So I worked hard to become. That you can walk from the slums of Kibera and become a professor on this earth. It does not come when you have a spirit of receiving handouts. And I'm saying this genuinely. That is how people are walking around and telling us, Waluya, there's no problem, tutawapanga. Unajua kupanga ni nini? Handouts. Meleni na endelea, nina swimu, utembea, maumiu, yasikie. I want us to move to the center. At the center, where there is wisdom, where there is truth, where there is beauty, where there is fulfillment, where God sits. But if we keep dancing around the periphery, and people coming around to subjugate our minds so that our young people can no longer aspire, Vihiga will remain what it is. I cry for our education system, Your Excellency, as I finish. I cry for our education system. And I don't want to talk about what is going on in schools. That is Professor Magoha's headache. But some of us know the reason why. Education is a soft area. That primary school teacher is not a fool. That primary school teacher will carry education for you. I cry for our schools. I saw your statistics. But I want you to be more, I want you to tell us more. I was asking, how many of our boys went for medicine from Vihiga during your term of 4 years? How many doctors have we produced from our schools? How many engineers? How many lawyers? Your Excellency, until you become unrealistic, you'll not get to the bottom of the matter. Me, I want to know, how many doctors has Vihiga High School produced? Senende, Emusire. Yes. Then we are talking, because some of us are exiting, we are retiring off. Who comes next? Our schools, Vihiga. You know, we have reached a level where your heart cries for your county. So I want Vihiga, Your Excellency, this scorecard is good, and I'm glad you're modest, you said 71. That told me something about your character. Somebody else would have said 99. Yeah, that tells you the character of a person. And some will go and say, you know, Mundo Otichiro, me, have we ever had a girl with you? No. We are just common because we come from Vihiga. This is our home. So can you be unrealistic? By the way, the person who invented these bugs, the ones we are seeing, was decided to be unrealistic. And for 15 years, he kept on trying about it. Anapeleka juu, anakimbia kwa ukuta, inapasuka. Until the wife ran away. You know, they always run away, by the way. When things are not going well. The wife ran away. And people ran to him and told him, why are you being unrealistic? What is realistic is to light a candle. Wacha tu msimame utaona. But because he chose to be unrealistic, look at how much he has influenced human civilization. Even in this tent, how many lights? Then Bunyore, then Tiriki, then Maragoli, then Kenya, then the world, lights everywhere. Thomason chose to be unrealistic. It is the people who choose to be unrealistic.